What's going on, guys? I am back here at Ron Hoover RV and Marine in Corpus Christi, Texas, taking a look at this beautiful Jayco Eagle Series travel trailer. This has to be one of the best looking exteriors I've seen on a travel trailer. Now, if you get up close, you can kind of see why. Very nice metallic use in the graphics here on the side. Nice front cap to it. And I love how a lot of manufacturers are going more towards this white exterior versus, you know, kind of the beige, the grays, and the darker exteriors that you've seen. Overall though, this thing looks really nice. Hang tight, you're not gonna wanna miss this video. Let's take a look at the numbers. So this is heavy. This travel trailer has an 11,995 pound gross vehicle weight rating, rides on twin 5,800 pound axles, 16 inch E-rated tires, and these are Goodyear Endurance tires, and it has a cargo capacity of 1,159 pounds. This is a big boy. This one, if I had to guesstimate, I'm gonna guess is about 36 feet long. Very, very interesting in terms of how they're applying a lot more fifth wheel technology to travel trailers though. This is a super cool unit. So before we dive too deep into it, let's take a look around this unit. This utilizes the Goodyear Endurance tires. A lot of people are gonna be a big fan of those, US manufactured tires. The Goodyear Endurance tire is pretty much standard on all Jayco units. They made that switch a while back. Also has the Cree 3000 suspension from Moride. Nice improvement over your traditional lack of any suspension on travel trailers. This has the ground control 3.0. So this has electronic leveling, something else you typically don't see on travel trailers. So it's refreshing to see that Jayco's putting it on some of their travel trailers. From a slide technology, the front slide over there is rack and pinion. This slide is cable driven. I kind of would have wanted to see it the other way around. That slide being smaller, I would have preferred to see the cable driven and this one use rack and pinion. It is what it is. This utilizes a 12-inch I-beam frame. LED lighting, full walk-on roof. It is wired for a Furion wireless backup camera. Coming around this way, rack and pinion slide over here. I would have assumed they would have just put rack and pinion slides all the way around, but they do utilize a cable-driven slide on the other side. You have an awning on this slide, as well as an awning up here. You can see your stabilizing legs down here, as well as your electric tongue jack up front. And this is a smart jack, so it essentially remembers where you set it and it can return to that position. It's essentially required for this leveling system too. Plus you have this really great storage tray up front, something that's very unique for Jayco. And you have twin LP tanks right there. Taking a look at the front storage, thin door, but very dense material. So you have a huge pass-through storage here, typically unseen on travel trailers. And I like how they've covered up components, which is also really nice. Coming around, you have power out here, cable connections for TV if you bring one out, plus you have some outside speakers. Let's take a look inside of this Eagle 330 RSTS. This has the Moride step above steps on it as well. Taking a look inside, it is a very, very nice rear living room floor plan. Love the fact they utilize this space here. You can put whatever you need here. You know me, guys, I'll put a coffee station there. Lots of storage, up here. Plus you have more storage here. This can also be utilized as storage for brooms, things like that, plus a coat hanger. More storage underneath. Plenty of room for pots and pans down there. Nice Whirlpool refrigerator. This is just a double door. So traditionally you've seen kind of the French door with the pull-out drawer. This one doesn't use that. Has a nice stove. Plus lots of drawers here on the side. Nice compact refrigerator. It looks like a full residential one, but I don't think it is. No, it's compact. It just has this incredibly large trimming to it. Interesting. Still looks very nice. Good size island. You have drawers here, cabinetry there, more cabinetry here. Plenty of room for your trash can down there. I like it when the cabinets go all the way up to the bottom of the island. You have a big pantry right here with adjustable shelves. It's a very impressive pantry. Nice glass front to it as well. You have your theater entertainment center right here. I love the use of two-tone wood trim, and all the materials here just look beautiful in the two-tone. You have your dark woods right here, and then you have your white right here, plus the dark surround area around the fireplace. And you can see the speakers entertainment center right there. Your sofa's back here. This folds out into a sleeper, traditional with rear living room floor plans. Plus you have nice cabinetry up there, nice window valances, your theater seating's here. You have two more chairs underneath the bed in the bedroom. Nice table. I like it when they use kind of this rustic look to the top surface. I really like the lighting fixtures in here too. I think they give it a nice kind of upper scale, sophisticated, luxurious look. You have your antenna right here. This is going to be your Wi-Fi booster. And this has a whisper quiet air conditioning system as well. So it has a whisper quiet return air right here. When we get to the bedroom, we'll see what's back there. This also uses a really nice intelligent management system here. Manages everything, lets you turn your lights on, lets you essentially control your slides, control just about everything from here, and it lets you know if there's any type of faults or issues with circuit breakers, things like that. Maybe that's where the control panel would typically go if you don't have that. That's my theory. Taking a look in the restroom. A lot of space in here. Now this is pretty much a full residential shower. Very, very nice. Very nice ceiling heights in here as well. So you really don't have to worry about hitting your head. You could probably be upwards of 7 foot tall and comfortably fit in these. Check out this countertop space. It is huge countertop space. I don't think I've seen a travel trailer with more than that. Nice vanity. Everything's really nice there. Moving on into the bedroom. King size bed in a full extended slide. Lots of space in here. Plenty of room on each side to get on the bed. Yeah, well, not so much on this side. You probably have about 10 inches on this side. It looks like there's a separate radio down there as well. Whisper quiet air conditioning system in here also. Beautiful, beautiful closet area. I mean, it just absolutely looks fantastic how they've done all this. Taking a look back here, more access to it. Very, very nice. And then on this side, also more access. It would appear as if these are large enough to house a washer and dryer. I just don't see connections. Doesn't mean that you can't do it. Doesn't mean there aren't connections somewhere in here. I just don't see them. Lot of room here. That full extension slide gives you a tremendous amount of room at the foot of the bed, which is also really nice. They already have your TV mounted in here as well. And a great wardrobe here at the end of the bed. Overall, this is a really, really impressive travel trailer. Definitely, it's something that if you're looking for a non-fifth wheel, you're looking for a bumper pull travel trailer, this is something you might want to consider. Now, I would absolutely recommend you only put this thing behind a 3/4 ton and up truck. I don't care whether it's gas or diesel, but half ton is not going to tow this well, and you're going to have a lot of issues, especially with tongue weight. So 3/4 ton and up truck for something like this, even a 1 ton single rear wheel truck would be a great truck to tow this, give you a lot more control than anything lighter than that. So just keep that in mind. Anyways, guys, I sure hope you enjoyed this video. If you haven't had a chance, please leave a comment below. Take a moment, subscribe to my channel, give me a thumbs up, and we'll talk to you again very soon.